Next up, we've got a real cracker.
Is it casual Friday?
What's going on here?
Oh, wait a minute. Yellow tracksuit, sword. We're doing Kill Bill myths.
The fans can't get enough of our martial arts myths. And in fact, since the ninja special, we've been inundated with requests to do the coffin punch scene from Kill Bill.
That's the scene where she's buried alive and she punches her way through the casket, climbs through 6 feet of dirt with her bare hands.
Right. No sword, right?
There's no sword.
Okay, put the sword down.
Yeah, don't hurt yourself.
It's a chilling scene that nightmares are made of, as our yellow-suited heroine literally gets buried alive. Trapped 6 feet under, escape seems impossible. Unless, of course, you are a trained martial arts assassin. So, undeterred by being interred, our heroine uses a series of 3-inch power punches, cracks the casket, worms through the soil, and lives to take her revenge. But is such a death-defying deed really doable?
All right, you guys, how do you want to test this one?
Well, I think the biggest issue is going to be the fact that she didn't have a lot of room to punch. She only had about 3 inches. So we have to see how much force you can generate from just a 3-inch punch.
Then I think we should get a real coffin and see how much force it takes to break through that.
All right, well, assuming we can punch through the lid, then we need to find out if you can dig through 6 feet of dirt with your bare hands.
Well, before I even get to that, how are we going to test force? Last time we tested the force of a punch, we almost broke Tori's hand.
Yeah.
Okay, well, I got a brand new technique. I guarantee you no one is going to get hurt.
Last time they tested punching power, Grant's invention busted more fists than myths. So this time, he's gone high tech.
I've got a tech scan flexible sensor, plugs into a USB evolution handle, and that goes into my computer. And the computer will be able to record the exact amount of force applied to the sensor.
Once the sensor records the punch, the computer then converts the blow to pounds, giving a total amount of force applied. So, armed with Grant's weapon of choice...
You ready for the fury?
It's time to test what power of a punch the guys can pack. Our very own Italian stallion shapes up first with a full-arm jab.
Go. Nice.
Ooh, look at that.
Okay, stand by.
And Grant's reader records the result.
Okay, so it looks like your peak there was 1,430 pounds.
Ooh!
Yeah.
But of course, in the movie, the heroine only had 3 inches of punch power to bust through the box. So Grant resets and Tori refocuses, this time from 3 inches.
Did it register?
It did register. 781 pounds peak.
What? Are you serious?
With Tori down for the count, the others see if they can do any better. But punching prowess is notably absent. Boom Boom Belechi, 785 pounds. Knuckles Byron, 362. And Iron Man Imahara, 612.
You know, that's not a lot of power. But you know what? We're not trained martial artists. And in the movie, she was. So why don't we find a real martial artist, see if he does any better than we did. Let's go.
All right.
With our trio unable to punch their way out of a paper bag, they head off to meet a real punching pro, mixed martial arts maestro, John Fitch.
How often do you get to meet an actual professional MMA fighter? But we get a chance to actually work with him and measure how much strength he has in his punch. I mean, this is like a dream come true.
But does Fitch the Fist have what it takes to tackle this coffin punching myth? Well, here's one way to find out.
In this corner, weighing in 170 pounds, John Fitch. In this corner, weighing in at 175 pounds, from the mean streets of Monterey, California, Tori Boom Boom Belechi. Let's get it on!
Tori's mom, in fact, any members of the Belechi family, may want to avert their eyes. Yep, in less than 1 minute, Boom Boom's doomed.
That's it, good night.
Meaning Fitchy's the fighter they're after. So now it's time to crunch the numbers.
We brought our whole measurement system and we're going to measure his punch force. I'll take his actual fighting glove and calibrate that with our punching bag and see exactly how hard he can punch. Ready, set, go!
With a round arm right, John Fitch fetches a healthy result.
Okay, so your peak punch force was 7,144 pounds.
Holy crap.
Not too bad.
Not too bad. Well, it is 5 times harder than Boom Boom's best blow. But the real test has to be at 3 inches while lying down.
So this is our makeshift casket. You're gonna lay down on your back and punch up at the sensor.
The fist assumes the position. Cramped as though in a casket, it's this punch that's key to this myth. So what's the verdict?
So check this out. Your force on your back at coffin height, 1,482 pounds.
So a trained fighter can 3-inch punch with 1,500 pounds of force. So now the boys need to bury themselves in this mess. And that's where Carrie comes in.
I'm gonna make it as realistic as possible. So I'm gonna use all the same materials. I'm gonna make it all the same size. And then we can see for ourselves if we can punch through a real casket.
It's 3/4-inch pine made to funeral and movie specifications and comes with a see-through side for testing purposes. Then there's the gravesite. That's Tori's contribution.
So I've come up with a design to test this safely. What I'm gonna do is build a box that will hold the 6 feet of dirt. And then what I'm gonna do is raise that up off the ground 4 feet with steel legs. And then what I'm gonna do is put the casket underneath that box. Once I have the casket in, we have the dirt in place, and we can start testing whether or not it's possible to break through the casket and dig through 6 feet of dirt.
More on that later, because right now it's on to the punch itself. With John Fitch unavailable, that's down to Grant. And no prizes for guessing his design.
That's right. I'm gonna build a robot. Using the robot, we'll match it to John Fitch's punching strength, and then try and punch through the coffin lid.
And thanks to the wonder of editing, it's a case of no sooner said than done. Voila, a robotic punching machine that can give the coffin a fearful coffin.
I call it the RoboFist. Here's how it works. First, air comes into the regulator, gets regulated to whatever pressure I want, gets stored in an air tank. The air tank goes to a high-flow valve that lets air go really fast. That gets split into 2 tubes that go down to the bottom of the piston. Now, when those fire, these 2 valves allow air to come up very quickly and goes whoo, very fast. 3, 2, 1. I think it's working.
And that means RoboFist is ready for a test.
And I'm just gonna dial up the pressure until the robot can punch as hard as John Fitch.
Remember, even with a tiny 3-inch punch, John Fitch managed a whopping 1,400-pound wallop. Grant's going to have to match that exactly.